Hey, hi, this is old Unicycle Al, and in here at Unicycle City, we're going to do a little lessons on riding a unicycle, what I call Unicycle 101. In the pre-check, we've gone through, we checked the tires, I've got these up to 40 PSI. My pedal, it says right pedal, is on the right side, got my seat forward, and the clamp locked so the seat won't twist, good and tight. Get a lot of torque on a seat when you're riding because your pedals have to keep from twisting right and left as you start climbing hills. Anyway, I like to go through a few things with people. Make sure you've got the pedals on the right direction, which we've covered. Should be dressed properly. I like to wear tennis shoes. You don't want your shoestrings any looser than that or they'll get wrapped up in the pedal. Sometimes I even force them down inside the other shoestrings. Keep them out of the way. You get your pedals, shoestrings wrapped up, it's going to twist you up. And don't wear open-toed shoes. No flip-flops, no thongs or anything like that. Don't go barefoot. Get on a good pair of shoes, and even shoes with a heel are not bad because sometimes you want to catch that heel in the back and keep it from sliding off your pedals. You're going to be putting a lot of force forward. Unlike a bike, you don't get a coast on a unicycle. Unlike a bike, you got to put forward and reverse force on your pedals too at times to keep the pedals turning. Anyway, so pants, shirt, should have on a shirt. Got my helmet on order for this, something to protect your elbows and knee pads. Today we're just going to do stationary learning. Sitting in here, here's a good spot. I'm kind of down here in the basement where nobody knows I'm doing this in case I make a fool of myself. Down here where I'm not going to tear up any good walls. Got a post over here that's solid. Some walls here and then a cabinet that I could come along and ride on along. Down in the basement. It's nice to have this carpet down there, a short pile. If you're going to get on the unicycle, get between the doorway. Here I've got 32, 36 inches near the basement wall, near a post. Works out well. Got the area clear. No pets around. No kids around. Or if you are a kid, no parents or adults around, but you're going to have a little privacy here during the COVID-19. You're going to want to spend some time by yourself. Unicycling is something you can definitely have a social distance of 6 feet or more. You've got 20 or 30 down here. But anyway, near the basement wall, this is a great area to start and learn. Riding a unicycle, you're not going to get it done in 1 week. Some people will learn in a week. Some young kids will learn in an evening if you got a long shoot for them to practice in. But we'll cover that up in Unicycle 1010. Anyway, start off. I like to put if you're left-handed, you may want to start with your left foot down. I'm right-handed. It's preference one, so I start with my right foot down, all the way down, so that wheel is in place. And once I step on it, I can keep it from rolling. If I step down now, it comes back towards me. It won't go any further forward and fly out in front of me. I like to hold the seat basically under you and then get it down underneath of you and then mount up on the seat by putting your left foot on. So basically, do it nice and slow. Get up, stepping on that pedal, all my weight's on the pedal, forcing it against the inside of my leg there, and then I get the second foot up. So really I'm putting weight between the two pedals and then the seat holds in place. Once I sit down on that seat, it's really in one place. Then you just practice for a day or two. Rolling forward, rolling back. Get the feel for what those pedals are doing. Right now I'm putting a lot of force and for the most part, kind of like to have the pedals right near the center of my arch. As you get better and ride more, you'll run with pedals right behind your front toes. Got a loose pair of tennis shoes, you can curl those toes around the pedal a bit. Whoop, there, about to, took a little spill, but anyway, it worked out. Good to have the tire pressure high, so you can spin and rotate on a point. If your tire pressure's low and squat it down, and I'm a heavy dude at 260 pounds, it's hard to turn and twist. Anyway, you can take off and roll if you want to. Basically getting a feel for that, maybe roll forward a little bit, back a little bit, and then I'm gonna roll on out here a ways, and then take a little ride around through here. It's an opportunity to get a little feel for unicycling and Unicycling 101. And you stop, grab it, get off, and put it down. And that's the way you take your first round. Thank you, and join back next few days. We'll do some more Unicycle 102. Everybody around their house have probably 20 items that they can use to unicycle on or behind, between carts and mowers and lawn spreaders and picnic tables and things like that. Back decks, we'll cover those. Next one will be out in the garage. Thank you. Have a good day. Take care and be blessed.